Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Eric here. I will show you how to install one of the MQTT brokers, Mosquitto, on AWS EC2 instance. You can see here that the MQTT broker is currently working and the ESP32 is sending and receiving data through the MQTT broker with the specific topics. MQTT is a lightweight, publish-subscribe network protocol that transports messages between devices in the constrained bandwidth communication environments, such as M2M, machine-to-machine, and Internet of Things. What's the reason why the MQTT broker is called the broker, not the MQTT server, is that the broker works as the bridge that the publisher and subscriber can send and receive messages from. In terms of topic, is to decide where to receive data when sending and receiving each data. Each publisher specifies a topic and the subscriber who subscribes to it receives the data. Conversely, subscribers who do not subscribe to the topic do not receive data. I will tell you more about MQTT in the next video when I make a service using it. It's going to be interesting. Okay, let's prepare the MQTT broker first. This is the AWS Management Console, and the regional setting is set to US West 1 in my case. It doesn't matter what region you have. Just please remember the region you set. You need to put the region radar on. There is nothing on the EC2 dashboard because I created a new account. Before making a new EC2 instance, we need to create a role of AWS IoT config access in the IAM. Later, we will generate the AWS IoT credentials from the console. Click on roles on the left menu, then click on create role. Select EC2 and click on next permissions. Search with the keyword IoT, then you can see there is AWS IoT config access. Select it. Click on next tags. You can add a tag for this role, but it's not necessary for me. I just skip it. Click on next review. Enter AWS IoT config access as a role name. Click on create role. You can see there is a role we just made. It's time to make an EC2 instance. Go to EC2. Use the search bar on top of the screen. It takes you where you want. Click on the instance on the left menu. There is no instance, of course. I need to make one. Click on the launch instances. There are a bunch of Amazon machine images. Select the free tier only. Then you see the Ubuntu servers. I select Ubuntu server 20.04 LTS, which is x86. The MQTT broker requires very low resources. You can play everything with the free tier instance. Select the T2 micro, which is free tier eligible, and click on next, configure instance details. In the IAM role dropdown, select AWS IoT config access you made. If you missed it, please make it first before creating an instance. Click on next, add storage. We don't need to add extra storage, so just skip it. For the tag, you can put the name on this instance. For key, name, for value, MQTT broker. You don't need to set them. It's optional. Click on next, configure security group. This is a default setup for security access. For now, there's no problem as long as you can access it via SSH. Click on review and launch. To access the server via console, we need to have a key pair. Let's make a new key pair. Put the key pair name you want and download it. After that, you can launch the instance. This was all about creating an EC2 instance with the IoT config role. It takes a few minutes to up. Time to grab a cup of coffee. It's been about 10 minutes. Let me click the instance ID for more information about my instance. The state of the instance shows that it's currently running. It's good to go. Time to open your terminal. You can see the key pair you downloaded before starting the instance. Change the permission of the key pair to 400. This means that it cannot be written or executed. Use SSH to connect to the server. you can find the public server address from the instance information page. Just copy and paste it. We have connected to the server. From now on, the task is to install the Mosquitto MQTT broker. The AWS blog explains everything we need to install. Of course, I followed this and did the same thing. There is a link in the description below. Please refer to it. This is the first way to install it. We have installed the Mosquitto broker onto our EC2 instance. Now we need to configure the bridge so that the Mosquitto broker can create a bidirectional connection to AWS IoT core. Leave them blank, but you need to put your region here. Mine is US West 1. Leave the rest blank. This is to create an IAM policy for the bridge. Done. Go to the Mosquitto certificate directory and download the Amazon Lucy certificate. Lucy certificate downloaded. This time, create certificates and keys. It's necessary to change the region at the end of the parameter. In my case, US West 1. A public certificate and a private key have been created. In order to attach the IoT policy to your certificate, replace the ARN of certificate returned above from the command line. The string I have already copied was the ARN of the policy. It's wrong. You need to have the ARN of the certificate. Now it successfully attached the IoT policy to the certificate and add read permissions to the private key and the public certificate. A total of 3 certificates are required to access the MQTT broker via AWS IoT on ESP32. I'll tell you again after the broker works properly. We now have a client certificate for our bridge. This certificate is associated with an IoT policy. This IoT policy will give permissions to the bridge to connect to AWS IoT core and publish and subscribe to any topic. The last step is to create the configuration file with our specific configuration for the Mosquitto Broker bridge. I just got the AWS IoT core ATS endpoint. This will be the endpoint where ES32 tries to access. Please keep this. It's time to configure for the Mosquitto Broker. Copy and paste the configuration from the blog and replace the address with your endpoint address. Now we can restart the Mosquitto broker to load this new configuration. We have confirmed that the broker is working in the process. Okay, it's time to have a simple test. AWS IoT provides a test client page for testing MQTT servers. Thanks to this, we can easily have a test. The MQTT test page address is also in the description below. You need to select the current region your server is in. I will subscribe to the topic as it is on the blog. Since I have subscribed to the specific topic, I can see all the data that came in here. Let me publish a local message to the Mosquitto broker running on the EC2 instance from the terminal. I can see the data I sent on the test page. You can also publish messages from the test page. I'll send a message through this. Through MQTT broker, the message was published and I was able to see it again from the subscribed topic. It works seamlessly and now it's time to set up the ESP32. The AWS IoT blog also presents a way to deliver messages from ESP32 to MQTT broker. I will complete the ESP32 code based on this post. First, I will make a header file called secrets. I copied and pasted what I needed here. I will fill it up one by one. The thing name is my ESP32. I put the SSID and password of my wireless router. I'll paste the previously received AWS IoT endpoint address here. Each certificate must be pasted. It's all created on the server, so you can find it and paste it in it. Let me show you how to do it. First, open the root CA certificate. Copy and paste all strings, including the begin and end. It's done. Let's move to the next one. The next one is the device certificate. Copy and paste the same way. The last one is the private key. All done. This completes the header file. Now I will complete the main part of the source code. After accessing the AWS IoT, this code works on two topics through the MQTT broker. It's sending not only the timestamp for the analog value connected to the GPIO every second via the topic ESP32/POP. It also subscribes to the topic ESP32/SUB to receive data that corresponds to this topic. The Arduino JSON library and the MQTT library are required for this code to work properly. There are lots of MQTT libraries, so please check the author. It's using MQTT by Joel, and the version is 2.5.0. I will also register all topics in the MQTT test client to check if the data is delivered properly. Let me change the serial speed. Lastly, I will send random data rather than the analog value on the public message because I don't connect anything to GPIO. This is all. All looks good and doesn't have any problems. Let's see the result. If you look at the serial monitor, it says the AWS IoT is connected. On the right test page, you can see the message icon on ESP32/POP. This is an indication that you have received the message. You can see the message coming in every 1 second as intended. This time, I'll send a message on the topic ES32/sub. As soon as I send it, you can see that the message is printed on the serial monitor. Awesome, it works smoothly. That's all for today's video. We have built a system for both the Mosquitto Broker on EC2 instance and ESP32 connection for AWS IoT. I hope it will be a great start for many interesting projects. The next project will also cover the detailed features of MQTT. Thanks for watching. See you soon again.